We are cousins from Maine. This is my little cousin. And he came out to Los Angeles visiting, and we saw how many food trucks there were. There's just tons of food trucks taking over the market. And so we were playing NHL 94 on Super Nintendo, and it hit us. My name is Sabin Lomak. I'm one of the cousins from Cousins Maine Lobster. You are here live on the Cousins Maine Lobster truck in LA, and it is raining cats and dogs.
It's raining a little bit today, so got caught up in traffic, but supposed to be here at 8 o'clock. This is the Bool barbecue truck. We sell Korean fusion food, Korean mixed with Mexican and a little bit of Brazilian. This is our commissary. This is where we park our truck. We replenish here. We ice up, fill the truck with water, put propane in the truck so the grill will be working, and we park it overnight.
My name is Mitchell Collier, and welcome to the green truck. It's a local organic farmer's market on wheels. This one runs on ethanol, and yeah, most trucks are just gasoline, and we have three others that run on veg oil, so we reclaim what goes in the fry later back here. Take that old oil, filter it, run it as biofuel or straight veg. Obviously solar powered, so we're off the grid. We give 10% of power back to Edison, which is a big one.
I am Eve Cook. I'm the general manager of Coolhaus LA. Come on in. This is our first brick and mortar. We opened just over a year ago. We started as a single truck, started from a little postal truck that my bosses bought on Craigslist for pretty inexpensive. Launched at Coachella in 2009 and since have grown to 9 trucks. This is our baby. This is T3, as we like to call it. It's a pretty simple operation. Obviously just taking a cookie, scoop and ice cream, put it on, and service is right there.
We serve Creole Cajun, soul food, so basically it's our own spin, our own twist on what they do in Louisiana and New Orleans. And we were looking into getting a restaurant, and you know, we just saw that it was so expensive to get into. Got into the food truck business and found out it wasn't as easy as, you know, look. I thought once I tweeted my 7 followers, they're all coming down to eat, and I saw it wasn't as simple as that.
I want to get into the restaurant business, but it's extremely hard to get into the restaurant business here. There's just so much capital that you need to get started. So I figured I would kind of segue my way into the business by starting a food truck. I think the greatest misconception is that there's a lot of money to be made in the food truck business. There really isn't. So whatever your concept is, it has to have a twist to it. It has to be unique.
The Snoop Dogg Cristos, the 2 waffles dipped in buttermilk, mac and cheese, fried chicken inside, deep fried together, covered with powdered sugar, maple syrup. And then we get that, we go to Jamie Foxx's house. Snoop has it, and everybody's going crazy over it.
So here is the inside of the truck. It's not glamorous. It's actually really chaotic, because no matter how much you organize, it's just disorganized. So we have our steam table. I just sprinkled some cheese on the mac and cheese, some jambalaya, got some syrup warming, some collard greens. So you just keep your foods in here. Try to keep it closed as much as possible. We'll put a pot on top of the grill to actually cook, a process that takes forever sometimes, but if you use, oh, a tip. If you use aluminum tray sometimes, it'll like boil your water in a second. So if you're like making rice or pasta, you can keep that. This is our sandwich prep area where we prep like our po' boys and stuff like that. We try to put our breads up neat as we can. Cause we have a lease truck, so it's not like a custom truck. When people buy their truck, a custom truck, they can be like, hey, I need 8 buns a day. So here's my individual bun holder. We don't have that. This is like OG ranchero truck style.
The reason I started this is this country has been dying for street food. And the culture never really developed here because we're such a regulated country. But if you look around the world, Europe, Asia, Latin America, it's interwoven into business life and everyday life.
like, I don't know, maybe 500 people a night. They love my food. They love it. It's very hard, like you don't know. It's so hard.
It is difficult, you know, it's not easy. Truck breaks down or there's a problem mechanically, that's your day, that's your week, and there's money being lost.
The gourmet food trucks help each other out. You exchange food and events, and you know, of course, obviously, you're closer to some than others.
It's just amazing. Some of the people are just the coolest people. That's why I gotta say food trucks are the shit. I wouldn't do it any other way.
You know, I mean, we're out there in the grind every day, and you know, we share a common denominator. Sometimes we hate it, and sometimes we love it, and we go through all of that together.
This by far has been my most rewarding culinary experience. It's this, to watch somebody wait a half an hour, 2 hours for a grilled cheese sandwich, get up to the front and bite into, rip it open as if there's a golden ticket in there, and bite into that, that makes my 17-hour day worth everything.
I answer to no one. I'm a true American. I create jobs, I support farmers, I do what I believe in. Not a lot of people can say they do that, so. And if I don't want to wake up tomorrow and work, nobody can say nothing, so. I choose my destiny.
I like when the people say thank you very much for the food because they love it, they like it, they enjoy it, you know? That's my best part in my job.
Still avoid. Don't do what you want to do. What do they want? And I think there's too many people out there that they come up with this really cool, kitschy name for a truck, and that's why they want to open a truck, and that's not going to do it for you.
And that was the point. You know, we're New England guys. We came out here. You can't get this food here. It's the same thing as if I left here and went back to Maine. You can't get good Mexican food in Maine. So a taco truck that you take for granted here, if it was in Maine, they would be making a killing. So word of the wise, if you're looking for a good investment, move to Maine and open a burrito shop. We'll be right back.